described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
AMBROSE Video Publishing Incorporated presents Great African American Authors, Program 8, 1993 to present.
Ernest J. Gaines' novel, A Lesson Before Dying, skillfully deals with the contradiction between the beauty of America's rural South and its violence towards blacks.
Title, 1993, Ernest J. Gaines completes A Lesson Before Dying. An older black man wearing a beret stands in front of an old white house.
Ernest J. Gaines has spent his life steeped in the rich cultural history of the black rural South. Indeed, he was born in 1933 into a family of poor fifth-generation cotton sharecroppers in Pointe Coupee Parish, Louisiana.
He smiles as a young man.
Gaines was so closely tied with his African-American history that he grew up in the old slave quarters of his ancestors on what used to be a slave plantation.
Cotton grows outside another house.
But he didn't reject this history and its violent past. He embraced it and the beautiful rural Louisiana landscape.
In a photo, he sits with a few older black men and a boy.
This love of black history and the South would be the main themes in his literary works. Nowhere does he do this better than in his 1993 masterpiece, A Lesson Before Dying.
On a book cover, a man in a field has his head bowed.
Set in rural Louisiana in the 1940s, the story focuses on a southern black school teacher, Grant Wiggins.
In a scene from a movie version, in a jail cell, a man paces while another sits.
Grant is forced by the community around him to educate a local black man, Jefferson, before he's executed.
Professor Tara T. Green, PhD.
The community has to come together because they know that this young man is innocent, but they want to make sure that the story that is told is a story that shows the sort of strength that he had. Then he has to go through an educational process.
More scenes are shown.
A process that sort of helps him to come to grips with who he is, but to not define himself simply in the ways in which he has been defined based on that oppression. So we see some hope by the end of that, right? We see Paul, who's a white man, who feels reluctant to have anything to do with the death of this young black man. But we see him at the end, and we feel as though there may be some hope for race relations in this rural, isolated community.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.